But it's not halal. It's not the halal itself.
Halal is the food or
halal. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Anyway,
so what I'm saying, all I'm telling him is that Allah food,
okay,
according to the Quran, Jesus is God.
Okay, that's a different story now. You said before, when you were
talking to the
verse that you said to us, is that you can prove that Jesus is the Kalima of Allah.
But he is, you know that. It's that which, I don't have
the
to prove it.
Which is the word of Allah. I accepted that, no problem. I agree with you.
Okay,
he is the Kalima.
So why don't I agree with you?
So what you just said now, a secondary statement, that in the Quran, that Jesus is God, which is a ridiculous statement.
No, that's what I said. His Kalimatullah or his God is the same thing.
That's not the same.
Do you know why?
Go ahead, tell me.
Is Kalimatullah created or uncreated? Is Kalimatullah created or uncreated?
Which one?
The word you speak, any word.
It's uncreated.
Okay, is Isa Kalimatullah? Is Isa Kalimatullah?
Is Isa Kalimatullah? Okay.
No. You can't change your mind now, right?
The word, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's words are uncreated, yeah?
And Isa is his word as well, right?
No, hold on. Isa is his kalima, his command. He emerged as a result of his command. Listen, you have to understand something. The word kun, command means like if I instruct you to do something, yeah?
That's what I'm talking about.
Hold on, my dear. You're trying to... Hey, do you want to learn or do you want to see you speak?
But I can't learn nothing from you.
Okay, you can't learn anything from me. It's quite an arrogant position to take, isn't it?
But it's an arrogant position because what I've been telling you right now, I've been talking to other Muslims, they give me no answers, you will be the same.
Okay, fine.
I'm sure.
Let me. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gives, in the Quran, in many chapters, for example, chapter 2 of the Quran, chapter 36 of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِذَا قَضَىٰ أَمْرًا فَإِنَّمَا يَقُولُ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونُ. That when Allah, he decides upon a matter, that all he says to it is kun, kun, which is two letters in Arabic, كَفَرُونَ, which means be, in English, be, and it is. So this word, kun, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is a command from him that then creates something. All he has to do is say kun, and then he is created. You see what I mean? That's how we conceptualize it in our theology. Any question?
No, what I'm saying to you is the being of Christ, according to the Quran, who he is the Kalimatullah. He himself, he is Kalimatullah, right?
Okay,
and you told me, and Kalimatullah is uncreated.
Okay,
you told me it's uncreated.
So
if Kalimatullah, if Kalimatullah is uncreated, and only God is uncreated, and Isa is Kalimatullah, that makes him to be God.
No, hold on. Let me go back to step one because I think you're not understanding my language a little bit, alright? What I'm saying to you is that the kalima, there is an actual kalima. Kalima means word. In Arabic, yeah? The word, you know what the word is. It's kun.
No. It's not only kun.
It is
whatever he says.
That's what the first thing says.
But it's not the only that.
No, but hold on. Are you listening? Hold on. Kalima is a particular word, which Allah...
The word of God is whatever he says, not only one word.
Okay, right. This, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I challenge you right now in front of everybody.
Okay.
Because you seem like you think you know what you're talking about. I'm going to challenge you because you think you know Arabic and you don't know how to speak Arabic.
No, I didn't listen to Arabic.
You just said to me you're correct in my pronunciation.
No, but I told you, I said the word kalima in Arabic and Farsi is the same. I know my language.
What? So what? It's Farsi. Farsi is a different language.
No, I know it's a different language, but the word you use, kalama, is the same.
Okay, but yeah, we just say kalama, we say kalima, the capital of lamb.
The meaning is the same. The meaning is the same. Kalam or kalima, it's just a bit of
presence. Different. You can't confuse languages together to try and understand. Like,
the meaning is the same.
There's also words that are similar between Urdu and Arabic.
So wait, I don't know what you're saying.
I'm saying to you here, this is a direct challenge to you, alright? Find me one singular tafsir of Surah Al-Imran, chapter 3 of the Quran, where this word is referred to, where Jesus is referred to as Kalimatullah, where any of the Mufassirin or the scholars who exegete Jesus don't say that the kalima here is not kun. Kun meaning be. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says be, and the thing is, if you use your logic, your false logic, then the universe has the same exact status as Jesus Christ. There is no reason for you to refer to Jesus Christ as the universe. Because Allah said peace to Jesus Christ, what? Allah said peace to Jesus Christ, what?
But the word that Allah creates is not his word. this word is not Kalimatullah. As I said again, and I'm going to repeat, the only person in the Quran and in the universe.
You're confusing yourself, man.
But let's finish now. The only person, the only being that is referred to be Kalimatullah, colors to the Quran, is Isa.
Okay.
So why are you saying the word as well?
Let me give you an Arabic lesson. Since you've admitted you don't know any Arabic. Yeah, in Arabic there are some things which are called tarkibat. Tarkibat are when you put two things together. For example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in chapter number 91 of the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refers to Salih. He had a camel. He called it Naqatullah. Naqatullah. The Kaaba is referred to as Baytullah. What this means to say is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the Arabic language facilitates, Naqatullah means the camel of Allah. Baytullah means the house of Allah. No one takes this terms literally and assumes that Allah has a house which he lives in. No one thinks like that. Only someone who has no understanding of Arabic language like yourself, who's approaching the Quran in a way which is really an ignorant way, and he assumes that he can just try and pick and choose some words to try and make an argument. It's quite embarrassing.
Are you telling me
Yes, sir. The
word of God and Isa is different?
I'm telling you the word of God, that we know what Kalimatullah is.
I just want to know, is Isa the word of God? Is he or not?
Okay, word of God in the sense that...
In the sense of being, in the sense of speaking.
I'm telling you what we believe.
No. What you believe is not important.
Okay,
what is important is the Quran.
Yeah, okay. What we believe comes from the Quran.
So where does it come from?
It's embarrassing, man. Don't embarrass yourself, please. I'm telling you something clearly, right?
It's simple. Is Isa Kalimatullah or is not?
Okay.
Is he or is not?
Yes, he is. But the way that we understand this phraseology, yes, Kalimatullah, is that he said be and Isa was. Like in chapter number 3, verse number 59 of the Quran. Listen to what it says in chapter number 3, verse 59. Let's see what it says. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إن مثل عيسى عند الله كمثل آدم خلقه من تراب ثم قال له كن فيكون. One more time, let me hear that, because the word in his, it's the same chapter that he's referring to where it says Kalimatullah. So maybe he can understand it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in chapter number 3, verse number 59 of the Quran, that certainly the similitude of Jesus Christ is just like that of Adam. Allah said to him, about him, kun, be, and he was. So we know here, this is an interpretation of what is Kalimatullah. The Quran interprets the Quran. We know Kalimatullah means kun, means that Allah said to him, be, and he was. That's it. Just like Adam. And in fact, this verse is meant to be a testimony to Christians like yourself, who say that Jesus Christ must be the Son of God because he had no father. So what about Adam, who had no mother and no father? Does it make sense now or no?
So you told us now.
Yes, go ahead.
The Kalimatullah is kun.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's right.
So that's the only word of God, yeah?
It's not the only word of God. No, but I said that in relation to, in the context of Jesus Christ, where he's referring.
But those two are completely different verses. The verse that he says Jesus is Kalimatullah, and the verse that talks about Allah as creation, is two different. The verse that talks about Jesus is Kalimatullah, and the verse that Allah talks about his creation is two different chapters. How do you put them together?
So what?
How do you relate them?
I don't understand your question.
You're relating Jesus as being Kalimatullah to when Allah was creating the world and saying be.
Yeah.
I want to know, what does that be going to be?
I've told you here in this chapter, chapter number three, verse 52.
So the chapter are different.
I've told
you the same chapter, chapter number 3, verse 52. It's not the same chapter.
So the chapter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, chapter 3, verse 59. إن مثل عيسى عند الله كمثل آدم خلقه من تراب ثم قال له كن فيكون. كن فيكون. In relation to Jesus Christ, it's the same chapter where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls Jesus Kalimatullah. So it puts everything together so someone like yourself doesn't become confused. That the kalima here is kun. because Allah says it in the same chapter that you're referring to, where he says his kalimatullah alqahu.
So that is still
means, you know, he says
but that is still means
alqahu. What is what the word alqa means?
But
what
is what alqa means? Let me say something. But it's still, even if it refers to kun, it's still kun is word of God.
So what?
So that means,
you're becoming embarrassing.
No, I'm not going to change my argument.
I think you should change.
But let me tell you what you said. You said kun is referred to kalimatullah, and kalimatullah referred to kun, right?
No.
Yes or no?
I said to you in relation to Jesus Christ, yes, correct.
So, but it's still, whatever, it's still, it means Jesus is kalimatullah, and the word of God is Jesus. It's still the same word. But it's still, I know you said kun, but it's still kun is word of God.
I'm sorry.
No, one second.
Are you alright?
One second. I say kun, yeah? Kun is kalimatullah, yeah?
Have you got comprehension?
No. Is kun kalimatullah?
Yes.
Is Jesus kalimatullah? So obviously there's only one word God has. Word of God is only one, right?
Oh, yeah, that's quite embarrassing, man.
Only one word of
that's
God, right?
Embarrassing.
Why is that embarrassing?
So what is the Quran then? Is it not Kalam Allah?
Is Quran Kalimat Allah?
Kalam Allah.
So the Quran is word of God?
Yes.
Is it God?
We say that it's one of the attributes of Allah.
Oh, is the attribute of God created or uncreated?
Uncreated.
But hold on, the attribute of God is not God, and only God is uncreated.
What?
The attribute of God, is not God, right? And only God is uncreated.
Who told you that the attribute of God is God?
Is it God?
You believe that it's part of God's nature? Yes.
I know, it's part of God?
Yes.
And is it God?
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he speaks. That is one of his attributes. We don't disconnect
his
speech.
I want to know, is the attribute of God God or is not God?
We say that we don't disconnect Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
But if it's not him, then it's disconnect. It's not him.
So like for example, let me give you an example. It's a good question. Alright, fine, I'll give you that one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Rahman Rahim. Yeah? Most gracious, most merciful. The scholars say that he's Rahman, he's most merciful. In and of himself he's most merciful. Some scholars say Ar-Rahim refers to his giving mercy, the fa'al, or the action of him giving mercy. So we say that these things are inextricably connected. Allah and his attributes are connected. We don't disconnect these things. That's what I mean.
But honestly, the Trinity is not discredited as well.
What?
So why don't you believe in that?
What?
But what's the reason you don't believe in Trinity? Because they are not disconnected.
Oh, okay, that's a good question now.
Do you know why?
I like the question. No, I like your question. Why don't I believe in the Trinity? Okay, so do you believe in the Trinity?
Of course I believe in the Trinity.
So do you believe that Jesus is God, yes?
I believe.
No, I'm just asking, let me ask you.
I can't tell you what I believe.
No, I'm just asking you. I want to know what your belief is, right? You believe Jesus is God?
Yes.
And you believe that the Holy Spirit is God, yeah?
Yes.
And that the Father is God, yeah? And that God is what? But you see, here you have an issue here, don't you see? I think the people here can see the issue. Pardon? No, I'll tell you. I'll substantiate my statement with evidence. This is an issue. When you say you have three in one and one in three, why is this an issue? Because this is illogical. It's inconsistent. It's incoherent. Now, if we think about it, you can't have three in one and one in three. And I'll tell you why you can't. If you said to me, listen, I want you to understand the difference. I have a cake. You know a cake? You know what I'm saying? In Iran, they have nice cakes. Put a cake here, and you split it into three parts. You say, is it possible to have one thing that's split into three? I say, yes. It's logical to say that you've got one cake that's split into three parts. Right? Now, if I say to you, if you stop there, then okay, maybe there's some understanding. But you go a little bit further than that. You say that no, each part of this cake constitutes the entire cake itself. So each part of those three parts is the entire cake itself. And the cake itself is one. That is a contradiction. Do you understand how that's a contradiction? So it's a logical contradiction that Christians understood. And how do I know that Christians understood this logical contradiction? Because you had different groups of Christians. You had modalists, and you had three Trinitarians, or three tritheists. tritheists believed literally in the idea of three gods. So because they wanted to get rid of this confusion, they said Jesus is God, they said that the Holy Spirit is God, and the Father is God. And that they're all three separate gods. And they therefore said that there are three gods. That they are called, what they called, God, tell me now, you should learn now. What is this called? No, seriously, I'm not trying to put you in the spot.
You misunderstood.
Let me just finish mine. These are called tritheists. The tritheists said that there are three gods, not one God. Now, modalists said, no, in fact, what you have is one God, but it's divided into three parts. Why did they say that? Because they saw there was a confusion. They saw there was a problem in the Trinity. So they tried to solve it by saying, no, it's not three in one and one in three. They said it's all one God, but it's divided into three parts. Now, the problem with your position, which is the position that is taken by the Nicene Council in 325, May the 18th, at 12 o'clock, when they sat together and decided to do, you know what I'm saying, understanding what is the doctrinal creed of Christianity, is that they said that God is three in one and one in three, which constitutes a logical contradiction. It's a problem. It's like maths. If I say to you, 1 + 1 + 1 equals one, then you know it's a problem.
Can I talk now? I'm not one human being.
Are you?
I'm one human being, right?
You're one human being.
But I don't really understand how am I one human being. Do you know why? Because I have one body, right? I have a hand and I have a leg.
Oh.
But you know my legs. You know my legs.
Yes.
It's not my hand. Right? You believe that? My legs are not my hand, and my hand are not my legs.
Oh.
But I still have one body. How come?
But your leg is in my body.
No. But I have one body. I have one body.
Yeah, but your
but
leg
listen.
Is not a body.
But listen. Wait. Listen carefully.
My friend.
Peter. My little talk.
Peter. Can I ask you a question?
No. I have to finish.
I'll give you a chance. Go.
People say,
yeah.
I have one body.
There's one body.
Yes. My legs and my hands, they both are part of my body, right? But still, my hand is not my legs, and my legs are not my hands. So how come there are two different beings of me, but it's only one?
Peter,
how is that possible?
Peter, listen to me carefully.
Yeah, but right. This is being as well.
Peter.
And then being as well.
Peter.
But it's
still one thing,
it's not two. But let me tell you something. Let me tell you something now.
They believe each person is 100%.
The hand is not 100%.
You believe God is only one. Is he all powerful? So the power of God, yes? Is it created or uncreated?
It's uncreated. It's part of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
I know it's part of him, but it's uncreated, yeah? But his power is not him, right? And
no,
he's
no,
not his power.
No, we didn't say that.
But you believe in
that? I never said that.
So Allah is his power? Is Allah his power?
He is everything he describes himself as.
So
he is Al Qawi. So.
No, wait. Second question. I don't understand. Let me finish. For example, is mercy of Allah, is it his anger or is it different? Is anger of God his mercy or not?
Obviously, it's different.
Okay, wait. And they both are uncreated, right? They both. Okay. Wait. But you just told me the power of Allah is not separated from him.
That's right.
So you're telling me his power is himself?
He is part of. He is named as Al Qawi.
No, not the name. You're telling me the power of God is himself.
He is named as Al Qawi.
No, I'm not talking about name.
So he is named.
I'm talking about
name.
The actual power of God.
So he
which is
named
with him.
As Al Qawi, that's it. So we say that his attribute.
Listen,
is that he
God
is
doesn't have an attribute. God doesn't have an attribute. Does he need his attributes?
What are you talking about?
Does God need his attributes?
This is embarrassing, my friend.
How is it embarrassing? God doesn't need nothing, yes? God needs nothing. No.
I'm gonna warn you. I'm gonna warn you, Peter. Peter, listen to me.
God
listen,
needs
listen,
nothing.
Listen.
But he needs his attributes.
You said he needs his attributes. You said that.
Can he speak without his voice?
Listen, okay. Peter,
can he do something without his power?
Listen. I have to warn you that if you're gonna have a very intellectual discussion where you don't comprehend basic things, that I don't think is fitting, and I'm not saying this in an Arabic way, for me to talk to you, because you have to equate yourself with basics of understanding, you know, of how to interpret certain things. Because if you're going to make yourself confused, you're making yourself
confused.
You're confusing yourself and everyone around you.
Are you telling me the word of God is created, right?
I didn't say that. When did I ever say that?
It's not uncreated.
The words of Allah, the Quran and stuff, of course it's uncreated.
So is Quran God?
It's part of his attributes.
Is it God?
It's part of his attributes.
Look, explain that to me, yeah?
Okay.
Quran is uncreated.
No.
Quran is uncreated. Allah is uncreated. Quran is not Allah and Allah is not Quran.
I didn't say Quran is not Allah and Allah. That's what you're saying.
Are you saying that? Do you worship the Quran?
Hold on. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For example,
you said Quran is uncreated.
Listen, man.
Worship the Quran. Why?
Listen. You're confusing yourself.
No. He doesn't understand you. He's a Christian. He doesn't understand your belief.
Let me ask you a question, right? Do you believe?
You're asking many questions.
Who's asking who's the question? Right. Listen. Is God merciful in your tradition? Is God merciful? So does God have? Does God show mercy?
Yes.
He shows mercy.
Yes.
All right. Is that showing mercy part of God?
It's God.
Is that showing mercy part of God?
It's showing the mercy of God.
I'm talking about the showing of mercy.
It's God.
The showing of mercy.
The showing of mercy is God.
Okay, so you're saying that they're both the same thing. So you've said to...
But I believe it's two in one. God is one in many. Look, let me tell you something. Let me tell you something.
What are you saying exactly?
What I'm saying is that God has the power, yeah? And he has a knowledge.
Okay.
Okay?
Alright.
Okay. The knowledge of God, yeah, is not the power. Yes? And the power is not the knowledge, right. Yeah? But they both are God. And it's still one God.
So
that's what I'm saying. I believe God doesn't have an attribute.
You know what the word attributes mean?
Look. Yes.
Actually, can you tell me a definition of
it? Okay, for example, you say the tree is beautiful.
Okay.
Beautiful is the attribute of the tree.
Okay.
An attribute is something that is given. Right?
No, hold on.
Obviously it's given.
No. But it could be self-given as well. So I could refer to myself and say, well, give myself an attribute.
But God doesn't have attributes.
No, you're saying he doesn't have attributes.
Yeah, but the thing is, so attribute has
him,
a beginning.
So why are you referring to him as mercy?
But I'm saying,
that's an attribute.
You know, attribute is a word, it's an explanation.
No, so how would you define the fact that he's mercy? You said that God is merciful, yeah?
He is merciful.
So what would you define the fact that he's merciful?
He showed mercy. He showed mercy.
What does that mean? The fact that you're calling him mercy.
It means he forgives you.
The fact that you're calling him mercy. Cool, yeah?
Yes. Like,
what is that?
Forgiveness.
It's an attribute of God.
It's not attribute.
What is it then?
It's not attribute.
It's a description of
it's himself. No, it's himself.
But is it a description of himself?
It's himself. It's God.
So it's description though, isn't it?
It's God.
I don't think you understand English. Sorry.
You understand English? Let me ask you then. You understand maybe
an adjective.
No.
Hold on.
If I say if you ask Christians, do you believe
because you're,
God doesn't have an attribute?
You're contradicting yourself.
No, I'm not. But think about it.
You don't understand the English.
Once again. You just told me God has an attribute, yeah?
No, wait.
You told me God has an attribute. If God has an attribute, if attribute is something God has, that means he isn't the attribute that he has, right?
Who made that logic? You made that logic.
But that's what it is. How can you... Wait. Explain that to me. You have something
which
is you.
I think you're confusing
me. No. Can
you're confusing
me. One second. Can
anyone understand what he's saying?
Yeah, he understands.
Can you put your hands up and understand what he's saying? Do you understand this? Okay, excuse me, stop. Can you explain to me, because maybe your English is... Sorry, but maybe your English is a little bit better. Can you explain to me what this man is saying?
So basically what he's saying is that God, one example, mercy, It's him. That's it.
Okay.
It's not about him or saying all of that or let's say mercy or.
For example, God is love.
It's just
he is love.
If I say about him,